Right, Art 4, we're going to learn about rhythm today, and we need to kind of talk about music as well as art, and kind of marry the two, because music and rhythm go along with rhythm and art. So let's start to learn. So we've heard of rhythm in art before as our principle of design. It helps make your eye move around a piece of art, but let's talk about a little bit more about music. So really, in music, what is rhythm? Nice little definition here, the systematic arrangement of blah, 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 musical sounds. This is really hard for me to understand. So let's get a little more visual and a little more audio, a little audio in here.
Just remember, a rhythm is how we place our notes in time, how we place our notes in time. How we place our notes in time. How we place our notes in time.
Now, we're going to go to the next one. In class, we'll watch the whole thing, but just for this video, as you were listening to those sounds, I'm sure you kind of noticed that they were very, very repetitive. Even the notes on the staff were just repetitive. So what do we call that, though, in art? When something's repetitive, we typically call it a pattern. So this is my more simple translation of rhythm. It's a pattern of sounds, and it's or a pattern of visual elements. You could see it in music, and you can also see it in art. So let's break this down, though, because there's three different kinds of rhythm. So number one, we have regular rhythm, which is either a very basic pattern of sounds or of visual elements. So I like to think of it as this very basic pattern right here that you're seeing, or just simply clapping. Okay, very, very basic pattern. Our second rhythm is flowing. So it's also another pattern of sounds. It's a little different. It changes more. It's not so basic and regular and repetitive. You get a little bit more flow. You get a little bit more variety of the sounds that you hear or the visuals that you see. It's still predictable, but it's more like one sound kind of leads into the next, which is nice. So we'll take a look at some flowing rhythm. This is a very basic one. So we still have that pattern, but it's a little different. It's not just the same sound over and over again. You get a little bit more variety. Okay, and then progressive rhythm is like totally nuts. So you do have repetition of sounds or visuals, but it can kind of go crazy. It can kind of change and go in directions that you're not able to predict. It's really an unpredictable kind of patterns and sounds. It's an unpredictable kind of rhythm. So let's take a look at some, let's take a look at Charlie Parker. Okay. As you're listening, you can't tell where his saxophone is going to go. It still has notes, it still has some repetition, but it goes in crazy places. So the way I like to think of it to differentiate the three rhythms is like regular rhythm is like walking. It's very basic. Okay. Flowing rhythm is like skipping. Okay. A little bit more variety, a little bit more flow, a little more action. And then progressive rhythm is like you're running for your life or you're trying to do parkour. So check out those videos. You still use, you know, some basic steps to get to where you need to go, but you don't know where it's going to take you. So those are the three different rhythms. Now we'll look at some, we'll look at these audio examples in class. It'll help you differentiate a little bit more. But for now, let's skip ahead to the art. Because you'll, now that you've seen these three different rhythms, you should be able to kind of differentiate them when you see them in art. So for this first one, I think you could tell that this first picture is a very regular rhythm. Because we have a very basic repetition of our visual. It's the same shape pretty much over and over again. Okay. Same thing pretty much here. We have more of a regular rhythm. It's the same woman's body stance over and over again. Then we get into flowing. And as you see, again, we have a repetition, a pattern of visuals, but they change slightly. So there's some differentiation, some variety. And then we get into the progressive rhythm where it does use pattern to kind of lead your eye through the piece. But as you see through this pattern, it changes and you're not sure where it's going to end up. It gets kind of crazy. the good old Salvador Dali. Thank you, Salvador.